So, dear President Farrell, dear boards of the Chair Murray, dear Automatic Control colleagues, I'm happy and humbled to accept the Bellman Award, and also honored to be sharing the stage with Professor Galakulsoy and the other A²C² awardees. My profound gratitude goes to the colleagues who supported my nomination. I'm thankful and deeply moved by the selection committee and the A²C², which advanced the candidate in his mid-50s, an adolescent, by Bellman Award standards. There's one person younger, and he's with us today, Roger Brockett. The timing of this award, which recognizes the achievement of an American control systems researcher, carries significance for me. The Bellman Award came in the year that happened to be the 30th anniversary of my coming to the United States as a graduate student. It is customary on this occasion for the recipient to say a few words about their formative years and professional trajectory. I was born and grew up in a small city called Pirot in remote southeastern Serbia. I was fortunate that my provincial city had one of the top science high schools in former Yugoslavia, and my caring parents spared no expense to provide my brother and me with broader cultural opportunities than those that our hometown could offer. My undergraduate years at the Department of Electrical Engineering at the University of Belgrade provided me with two things. First, the toughest academic competition I've experienced before or since was during those 5 undergraduate years. And second, I met my future wife in our freshman math class. Before Peter Kukoric gave me a PhD opportunity, I had only an inkling that I might have a shot at some success in research. But within a few weeks of arriving in Santa Barbara, I had the fortune of solving a problem that had a reputation of being unsolvable, though I didn't know that. So things moved quickly with research from that point on. And I had Peter's unlimited attention. I could fill hours on being mentored by Peter. But let me just say that during those Santa Barbara years, Peter's enthusiasm and support for my work left me feeling that there was nothing more important in the world than what I was doing in research. At the same time, with everything I would produce or say, I had the training benefit of a keener, more unforgiving, and yet more nuanced critique than I would ever subsequently encounter as a researcher or academic administrator. Well, the areas present to me, the ones that probably came to mind first, are PD, backstepping, and extremum seeking. So let me describe how these interests started soon after I left Santa Barbara. Peter Kukoric, Richard Murray, and Art Krenner had a large project on controlling flow instabilities in jet engines. We solved those problems using reduced order nonlinear OD models of those flows. And it was clear that for a nonlinear control researcher, there was hardly a more fertile ground than fluids. The only problem was who would provide an OD reduction for me for the next control design problem to tackle. If fluids people spent their entire careers refining for a specific type of flow the reductions from the Navier-Stokes representation to ODEs, it was obvious I could not count on them for control-oriented reduced models. I had to roll up my sleeves and build control methods directly for PDs from scratch, because Riccati equations in infinite dimension to boot are not the way to extend PD control to the nonlinear case. The answer to the challenge of constructive PD control came in the form of continuum backstepping transformations, employing Volterra operators and easy to solve or subform PDs for the control gain functions. If you have interest in an example of this line of PD control research, I recommend the paper with Crohn, Bastin, and my student Vasquez, which has enabled stabilization of traffic flows in a congested stop-and-go regime. How I got drawn to extremum seeking is also interesting. In 1997, a combustion colleague at Maryland pointed me to publications from the 1940s and 1950s on what I would describe as an approach to adaptive control for nonlinear systems. Heuristic, but orders of magnitude simpler than what I had written my PhD on. Attempts at sleep were futile for several days until I figured out how to prove stability of that algorithm using a combination of averaging and signal perturbation theorems. If you wanted to sample one control paper from the last quarter century on extremum seeking, I recommend the one on model-free seeking of Nash equilibria with Tamer Bashar and my student Paul Freehoff. To my students and collaborators, I would like to say this Bellman Award is yours for your papers, books, theorems, and industrial products. As I mentioned students, I want to extend gratitude to two companies that have been the environments in which my former students have been able to thrive and leave a legacy. At ASML, control of extreme ultraviolet photolithography has improved the density of microchips by 2 to 3 orders of magnitude. At General Atomics, control of aircraft arrestment on carriers has enabled one of the most impressive and deployed recent advances in defense technology. I won't pretend that it is not a delight to see my name in the list of the 44 recipients of the Bellman Award. Scholars of incredible depth and engineers of stunning impact. I've studied the list. Amazingly, the numbers of American-born and foreign-born recipients of this U.S. award seem to be the same, 22 each. If you sought an example of how the U.S. is unequaled in extending opportunity to scientific immigrants like myself, you could hardly find a clearer illustration. It was impossible for me to miss in the list that after India, represented by 4 Bellman awardees, the second most highly represented foreign country is a certain little country, just a few percent more populous than the city of Atlanta, the country from which Peter Kokorovich, Drago Šiljak, and I came to the U.S. If I don't mention this in the hope of inspiring a few young minds in the universities of Belgrade, Novi Sad, or Niš, who should? I couldn't have made it here without role models and without pioneers who charted the pathways along which it was then not that hard for me to walk. Among them are people who have generously supported me over the years. Tamer Bashar, Manfred Morari, Art Krenner, Eduardo Sontag, Roger Brockett, Masayoshi Tomizuka, Gallup Pulsoy, Jason Spire, Grant Goodwin, Jean-Michel Couron, Petrus Yana, to limit myself to 10. I hope that in the remainder of my research career, I more fully deserve their support, as well as by other friends I don't mention here, but who are aware of the extent of my gratitude and respect. Let me close and thank you with a quote from my former department chair, who astutely observed to you guys in control systems, every other field is a special case of control theory. What if that's true? Thank you.